to all the partners of this great commission. We thank God every day for all your support and prayers. Our goal is to stay truthful to the word given and to help you make the changes necessary in order to turn your house into a house of prayer. The first scripture that I would like to share with you can be found in 1 Thessalonians 5:16 to 18. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Paul said to the Thessalonians, you must rejoice and you must pray. And also, you must give thanks. We must be thankful always. First, by offering an earnest and thankful prayer. Second, by giving a thank offering. To the Philippians, he said, in Philippians 4, verse 6, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. As you can see, always when you pray or present your petition to God, you must also be thankful. In this period where we are going to celebrate Thanksgiving Day, we must reflect to give thanks. This is not the time to be anxious. We know, usually in this period of holiday, a lot of people find themselves depressed. The word of Paul to the Philippians, do not be anxious about anything. Thanksgiving Day is a national holiday marked by religious observances and a traditional meal, including turkey. We at Lord Jesus House of Prayer consider it as a family day. It was first celebrated by the pilgrims back in 1621 as a harvest festival. That was a time for them to celebrate the harvest given. David probably was thinking about that time when he said in Psalm 100 verse 4, enter his gate with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. In this Thanksgiving season, we want you to give thanks to God, to praise his holy name. And the best way to do that is by giving. If you know a family that need a turkey, it's time for you to go out there and shop and buy turkey for a family that is in need. Or we invite you to go to LJHP.org. Click the link, online giving. You will see a place where you can give a thank offering. What is a thank offering? A thank offering is an act of thanksgiving, an expression of gratitude.
My brothers and sisters, this is how you give online when you go to LJHP.org. And you know, you go to giving online, and what you do, you click that. When you click that, that will send you to the page called Giving Online, and you will see the 7 sacrificial offering that you can see what type of offering it is. Like the first part is the amount that you can offer. The amount of offering that you can offer. You can click that and you will see all the options, $30, $58, $77, or whatever you choose to give. Or you can click in the option to know what type of sacrificial offering. We were talking, like if you want to give a vow offering, the sacrificial offering doesn't have the vow offering. It has the guilt offering, the fellowship offering, the drink offering, the grain offering, the burnt, the sin, and the wave offering. But if you want to give a vow offering, you have to go in the free will offering. There are 3 different free will offerings. First, you will see the option, the amount that you can give. The 3 free will offering, this is where you, if you click here, you will see the vow offering. You will see the tithe offering, the Jesus tithe offering, and the vow offering, and the first fruit offering, if you want to give a first fruit offering. And also, if you want to give a thank offering, you got to go down the page. Down the page, you will see an option for you to give something called, right here also you can give a personal prophecy offering right there. And you know, you can click and you will see if you want for a personal offering or a prophecy offering for 1 month or 2 months, 3 months or 4 months or 5 months. That means you want to receive up to 12 months, a personal prophecy for 12 months. And also when you go down the line, and you will be able, let me go down the line for you, you will be able to see tank offering, what we were talking about. The tank offering is simple. Okay, let me see where my cursor is. This is the tank offering. You can click and you will see all the options. If you want to give it $30, $60, or whatever you want to give as tank offering. And yes, this is how it's done. And if you can give $1, one child, you will have the option also. But also, I want to talk to you about something special about the building fund, because we are trying to see if we can build the first headquarter, a meeting place. You will have the option how much you can give. But right there also, this part called gift offering, if you want to give a gift toward the building fund, also a partner gift or a disaster relief fund. That means when there is a disaster, Lord Jesus House of Prayer can stand there. Also, we have a prophecy about LGHP building fund that God gave me back in September. You can read it and you will see the importance, how God will bless you if you give toward that. This will help you contribute, and help us in the things of God. And the Lord promise to bless you and to open for you the floodgates of heaven.
David said something special in Psalm 50, verse 14 and 15. Let's read it. Sacrifice, thank offerings to God. Fulfill your vows to the Most High and call on Him in the day of trouble. I will deliver you and you will honor me. God promised deliverance when we offer vow unto God, especially as a thank offering. And God said, not only I will deliver you, but I will bring you honor. A lot of people may see you in a bad state, but God said, I will use your circumstances to give you honor. What is a vow? A vow is a solemn promise to God, a pledge of thankfulness before or after receiving a blessing. It is like saying, I will give before I receive, or I will give because you, O God, have done this for me. We can give of our time, devotion, dedication, and resources. When you go to LJHP.org and click on Giving Online, you will have the option to give a Jesus vow offering, or when you go down a little bit, you will be able to give a thank offering. David said something else in Psalm 56, verse 12 to 13. I am under vows to you, my God. I will present my thank offerings to you, for you have delivered me from death and my feet from stumbling, that I may walk before God in the light of life. You imagine David, people, his enemies were pursuing him to kill him, and God provided for him deliverance. And he said, because you deliver me, because you have done this for me, I will always present my vows unto you, O God. I will present my thank offerings to you, for you have delivered me from death. You didn't allow the enemy to kill me. You allowed me to survive. I was about to fall, O God, and you have delivered me. And now I'm walking in the light of life. My brothers and sisters, in this season of Thanksgiving, we want to say thank you to God for giving us Jesus as a lamb sacrifice, for his sacrifice on the cross for us. And now we are free from the devil, from hell, from sins, and from the grave. I invite you once again to offer unto God thank offering and a special vow in remembrance of all the things that God has done for us. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the world, to heal the sick, to pray for the afflicted, and reveal unto them the purpose of God for their lives. Surely, the Sovereign Lord does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. To request your personal prophecy, go to ljhp.org.